An IV end time can be found by starting with the current time and adding the total time the IV will run, where the total time is equal to the total amount of fluid in milliliters divided by the flow rate in milliliters per hour. As an example, let's say at 9 p.m. you begin administering 600 mils of IV fluid at a rate of 80 mils per hour. What is the end time? So we start with 9 p.m. and then we add the total time the IV will run, which would be the volume, or 600 mils, divided by the flow rate of 80 mils per hour. So we'd have 9 p.m. plus this quotient here, which will be in hours. This would be 600 divided by 80. So we'll first use a calculator to find this quotient, and then we'll do it by hand. This would be 600 divided by 80, which would be 7.5. So this quotient is 7.5 hours. Before we determine what time this would be, let's go ahead and review how we would find this quotient by hand. 600 divided by 80. There are 7 80s in 600. 7 times 80 would be 560. We would subtract, this would give us 40. To keep going, we add a decimal point here, move it up to the quotient, add a zero and bring it down. And there are 5 80s in 400. 5 times 80 is 400. This difference here is 0, so we have a terminating decimal. Verifying this quotient is 7.5 hours. Now, to determine the end time, notice if we start at 9 p.m. and add 3 hours, that would take us to midnight, or 12 a.m., and then we have 4.5 hours left, or half an hour would be 30 minutes, so the end time would be 4:30 a.m. Again, to make sure that we understand this correctly, if we start at 9 p.m., and then instead of writing plus 7.5 hours, we'll write that as plus 3 hours plus 4.5 hours, where 9 p.m. plus 3 hours would be 12 midnight or 12 a.m., plus 4.5 hours, which would be the same as 4 hours plus 30 minutes, giving us an end time of 4:30 a.m. I hope this explanation helps.